Hey folks, this is Ben, and I am with Ben's Carts, hotdogcartstore.com, and learnhotdogs.com, and we're coming to you live right here on I Love Street Food Vending on Facebook. So you should be on the Facebooks with us. Okay, here's the deal. I have a whole list of stuff to go through today. Heather has been nice enough to create me an outline so that I can stay on track, because oftentimes I get sidetracked. But we are going to keep with the same mantra we've been talking about all week long. And if you've missed any of the videos, they're right down below. You need to pay attention to those videos, because if you want to make $20,000, $15,000, $10,000, whatever you want to make in October, I tell you how to do it. Exactly how to do it. And we have even more, okay? More bonus information so that you can make a ton of money the rest of this month. You got about 10 days left in this month, and then you got a whole month's worth of days left in next month. So let's make some money, and I'm going to show you how. A lot of people are going, well, it's time to, you know, slow down, not a lot to do. Nope. Wait till you see. If you haven't seen the videos this week, you need to be watching, because there is a ton of stuff that you could be doing to make money this fall, okay? Now, here's some more fall tips, and then I'm going to get to some questions that got sent in. And remember, you can submit your questions at any time just by posting in the comments, posting in the message, posting over on the blog at learnhotdogs.com. You can post your questions anywhere, and we'll try to find them, okay? Fall tips. Okay, have you thought about this? And I've got a bunch of tips for you here. More locations, okay? Apple orchards. Who thought about that? Apple orchards are great on certain days. Make sure you find out which days are the busy days and be there for lunch. You will make money. A lot of people go to the apple orchard, you know, they show up about 10 when the sun gets real high, 10:30, and they're going to pick a bunch of apples, and then they get hungry. About noon comes around, 11:30 comes around, they're hungry. Well, if you're sitting there, they thought they were going to go into town to a McDonald's, and now they get a fresh meal right here at the apple orchard. So apple orchards, next tip that I share today. School events. Tons of fall school events. Tons. From Oktoberfest events to fall festivals, you name it. They've got a name for it. Check out the fall events at your local schools. If you don't know how to look that up, go to your county, like mine's Sevier County, and I can go to Sevier County School Systems website and see all the events. Contact the school administrator or the superintendent's office and find out what I need to do to set up. We just had a vendor recently, another vendor. This is second one recently that was able to book all the schools games, all the fall games. They're doing the concessions. The school is sick of handling the concessions. And so the vendor, or in this case it's two different vendors, are going to do all of the football games. Imagine that. Imagine how many people are going to be there buying hot dogs and drinks, and all he's doing, or this most recent one, is 10% back out of profit, not out of gross, out of profit, 10% back to the school booster club. That's it. How can you beat that? It's like fishing in a barrel with a lot of fish in the barrel. Football games, I just talked about. Cross-country meets. Tailgating parties. Have you seen how many tailgating parties? There's a vendor, okay, over in Nashville, goes to tailgating parties, and he just shows up with his cart, sets it up as though he's doing his own little tailgating, and people come by and buy his stuff. He puts up a swooper flag and stuff and makes good money. Why wouldn't you? It just makes good sense. Okay, neighborhood block parties. Now, if you live in a neighborhood, you know, my neighborhood is like four people. It's you know, my mother-in-law, my brother-in-law, my sister-in-law. So that's East Tennessee for you in the mountains. So if you are live in a neighborhood, or you live near a town with neighborhoods, and they're going to have block parties. Most of the time, they advertise those block parties. You can call homeowners associations. Most of them are online. Or have a Facebook page. And you can get all the information you want about the schedule. You can contact them and go, hey, my name's Ben. Me and my wife have a small hot dog cart and catering company. And wanted to know, did you have food already set up for your block party you're doing? Or your fall festival or your fall games thing? Well, oh, you do? You're doing a potluck? Well, how would you like to have a cart set up on there just in case people don't always bring enough food? And, you know, would you like a cart? We are free that Friday. So we could be there. We can only be there for a couple hours, but we can come. And if you like it, you may want to use this in the future. And all of a sudden, you've opened a whole nother can of worms of potential people to cater for. Halloween. I know you've heard of trunk or treats, and all these things they do where the kids get to pull stuff out of the trunk, and you know, and it's just fun stuff. Churches as well do huge parties and celebrations in the fall, okay? And you could get in on it. A lot of last-minute yard sales and church auction sales or church gathering sales or fundraisers, and you can donate part of your proceeds back to the church, but you get to make money. And what you have is a captive crowd. It is just another way to make more money without spending a lot of time. Okay? So you could do just several of these over the next 5 to 6, 7 weeks and make 15, 20 grand. Why wouldn't you? Okay? Next thing. We have a question. I'm going to read this the best I can here. Let's see. Okay, it says, hi, I live in Georgia. The last time I was on live was in, September 2nd on the Hot Dog Vendor Radio Show. I've been trying to get one of your hot dog carts. The one I like is the King Kiosk, and I like it because the grill, so I'm able to do breakfast in the mornings and late lunch dinner. But here in Georgia, Cobb County, where I'm located, they do not accept hot dog carts. They actually do. I don't know who told you that. No county can restrict hot dog carts. So I'll go into that in just a second. But we already have vendors in Cobb County. I've talked to the Cobb County executives before. So they have a lot of people who do have the food trucks. Don't know what I can do. Can you please point me in the right direction? Like you said, it's a lot of ways to make money out there with the fall and winter season coming. I would hook up a lot of with soups and stews. I have so many ideas. Help. Okay. I think it's exciting that you have the ideas. I think that you've talked to somebody that's a moron. Here's what you do. I have an article on this. Go to learnhotdogs.com/liar. L-I-A-R. Okay, Heather, I'll put up the link here in the comments below. /liar. So go down there and go to that link and read that. That'll tell you what to do. Because more than likely, they don't have a code like that, okay, that says no street food vending or no hot dog carts. They can't restrict hot dog carts, period. It would violate federal law, okay? Now, if you find that there is some new code I'm unaware of, which would surprise me, that is that restrictive, illegally restrictive. All you have to do is go to stillonlearnhotdogs.com, is type in the search box on the right-hand side of the page, maybe the right over there, okay? Type in the word justice, and you will pull up free attorneys for the Institute of Justice, who will give you a letter that you can give to the city attorney or county commissioner's office or whatever you want and resolve the issue. But I know for a fact Cobb County allows vendors because we have vendors there already. We've got over 400 vendors in Georgia. Cobb County's just one of the counties we have vendors in. They don't restrict vendors. Unless it's something they've done in the last couple weeks that I'm unaware of, I'd be blown away that they restrict vendors because, one, it's illegal, and they can be sued for violating your constitutional rights. Not your state constitutional rights, your federal constitutional rights, which are your right to work. They can't restrict those. So, I don't believe that they have told you the truth. I believe you have talked to someone who may be shy some brain cells and who is ignorant to their own code and state laws. And I teach you in learnhotdogs.com/liar how to overcome that, if that is the case. As far as soups and stews, let me give you another video. It's called Why Just Hot Dogs, and you can search it, Why Just Hot Dogs. It's on YouTube. It's on learnhotdogs.com. It's because some states restrict what you can serve from a cart, okay, unless it's catering. Now, if you're doing catering, but if you're going to be at 5th and Main, you can't serve soup in Georgia. I'm just letting you know, right up front, okay? Can't happen. So you'll want to look at those codes and rules. You'll want to go through the free training. At the top of the page on learnhotdogs.com is free training. Walk you step by step, and it talks about why you can't serve anything but hot dogs when you're doing street location vending. Next. Okay. This is from the right here, I love street food vending comment. Angie says, what is good amount of dogs to bring to an event? Great question, Angie. I know it varies, but do you have maybe a general number that you bring? Here's the problem. It's so relative. And what I mean by relative is there's so many variables. How many other vendors are going to be there? How many people are going to be at the event? So those are two big ones. If there's 200 people expected at the event and there's 9 vendors, you might need to bring just 2 hot dogs. If there's 2 vendors and 900 people coming to the event, you probably need to bring 700, 800, maybe 1,200 hot dogs, because a lot of people eat 2 hot dogs at a time. So there's variables, but I do teach it for free. You can go to learnhotdogs.com, and in the search box on the right-hand side, type in the word event or event planning. I have an event planning guide that will help you determine. You'll ask these questions to yourself or to the event organizer so that you can know how to prepare for it. But let me give you a good rule of thumb. Events can be expensive. I talked about this yesterday or the day before, because you have so much to buy for an event and a lot of risk capital. But what is considered a good day for you? To me, if I go out for a couple hours and make $500, that's a good freaking day. Okay? An awesome day. So what if you planned on $500? That's 100 meals at $5 or 70 meals at $6, okay? What if you, roughly, okay, what if you just planned on that, took enough to cover 100 meals, and you went, that's my goal, and when I sell out, I'm going home. It's like an early vacation plan. Did you lose? Well, yeah, you may have not capitalized on all the opportunity that could have been at that event. But does it really matter? Unless you paid a fortune for the event. And then I would suggest going through my rules on doing events. You know, going through those steps. That information is free. There's no catch, no gimmick. It's free. You don't have to willy-nilly this business. You don't have to wing this business. You can start today just by going through and learning some stuff and avoid the learning curves. Avoid all of it. Now, I do want to tell you, go through that, okay, because there's variables. And then look at what makes the most sense. And figure low. I always figure low. But I always base it on what's a good day for me. 100 meals is a good day. So, yeah, I could have sold 300 if I had enough, but I don't really care. I got to go fishing earlier. I got to go play with my kids earlier or whatever. It doesn't matter to me. So that's how I base it. I hope that answers your question. If you need more information, let me know. Hey, I don't know if y'all know this, and you have to just be blind if you didn't see this, but right above, if you're on the I Love Street Food Vending Facebook page, right up here, if you should like and share that, you can do it multiple times. You can share it over and over, okay? We're giving away that tomorrow. That freaking awesome steamer setup. You get, it's free tomorrow. It's going to be ship free, everything. It's right there. Okay? Click it. Like it. Share it. Okay? And see what you think. Corey just said, selling out makes people want to come back. Abso-freaking-lutely, Corey. I love selling out. Even if I only brought enough for 100 meals, that's roughly 200 hot dogs. I am tickled pink. Tickled pink. I don't leave going, well, I could have sold another 300. I wish I'd have known. You could have brought enough, for 300, that'd have been 600 hot dogs that you didn't have room to store at home or in your commissary, and then been stuck out of that money. I don't like doing that. Until you get going, I wouldn't attempt that. Until you get going and have a reserve, a cash reserve, then I would gamble on those bigger odds, but I wouldn't gamble right now. I just do the tried and true. You'll find if you just stay tried and true and follow the rules and follow the steps, you will make a consistent freaking income and a good income, not a little bit of income. Realistically, college graduates leave college, roughly have somewhere around $60,000 to $80,000 in debt. Some of you probably have been to college. You have $60,000 to $80,000 in debt when you leave college, and the starting pay is less than $48,000 a year. That's less than $4,000 a month. The most basic hot dog vendor who didn't have access to this information or the information at vendorsunited.com, didn't have that information, was running it willy-nilly, is going to make at least $48,000 a year with no college education. All you have to do is run a clean shop, sell a good product, have a good value. That's the bottom line. And you don't have to work 7 days a week, 5 days a week. You can work 3 days a week. And you can work 4 hours a day for those 3 days a week. 12 hours a week. We have vendors doing it. I'm not BSing you. Get on Facebook right now. Go over to our big page, our facebook.com/Ben's Carts. Okay? And go to there and ask some vendors. Ask about 14,000 vendors. How many days a week they work. Many of them work 3, some 4 days a week. That's it. Some work 6 a month. Okay. Okay, early on, Owen Lewis asks, would you suggest going with Square? Okay. Square is the little dongle thing. They call it a dongle. That's a weird name. A dongle that goes into a phone, a smartphone that goes into the earphone, the headphone piece, the headphone jack, and it will swipe credit cards, okay? Well, believe it or not, at learnhotdogs.com, I've got 6 articles on the best method for capturing credit card sales. And I will say this, he asks, is it good to do this early on, or should I wait? Do it early on. It costs you nothing to do it early on. And you will get more sales. I walk around with no cash. Ever, ever, ever. Not because I have a rule against it. It's because everybody takes a debit card and it's easier. I never have to worry about pulling my cigarettes out of my pocket or something and dropping a $100 bill anymore. I got my wallet, got my cigarettes and my keys. And that's it. You can do the same thing. You can do the exact same thing. And you probably do. And most people do. Most people use debit cards now. So why would you cut away that portion of your opportunity, your business opportunity, by only accepting cash? Never do that. Always have some way to take. You can do the PayPal one, the Square one. There's so many of them now. Okay, Intuit has one now. QuickBooks has one. There's a blue million of them. Pick one. We right now probably suggest Square. None of them are perfect, but Square's easy. It keeps up with it. It's just simple. Okay, PayPal's another simple one, but I don't like PayPal. I hate the company as a whole. I think they're scum. Anyway, no, that's a whole different story. So I would pick one. I do your due diligence, do your research, and I'm not going to make fun of you if you go with PayPal, okay? And go pick one, but look at them all. There's ratings on all of them, Consumer Reports ratings. That will give you a good inclination of who to go with. And pick one of those. Always have a smartphone with that. If you are going, oh my gosh, can't afford a smartphone, that's another expense, they are expensive. Let me tell you what to do to save some money. Go to Walmart or go to Amazon.com. You can go to Walmart.com. Get one of those Cricket smartphones or one of those pay-by-the-month smartphones. You no contract, no credit check, no nothing. Square will send you the dongle for free. Intuit, QuickBooks will send you the dongle for free. Either one of those. Swipe their card, you have the money in your account within 48 hours. How do you beat that? And a good record. So yes, Owen, I would definitely take cards. Okay, I need to look something real quick. Let's see. Okay, Heather, if I know you can hear me, you Skype me because I can't see all the messages on the Facebook comments. And you had said something, you had sent me something and I missed it. So I apologize. Folks, we covered a lot already, okay? And I'm not done. I want you to make sure to go back and watch this if you got in late, because we give some awesome locations. If you want to make 15, 20 grand in October, it's doable. It's doable and is being done every year. I've done it. Other vendors are doing it. It happens every year, period. It's not a luck or chance. It's just knowing the right locations, right places, and I've been sharing those all week. Okay? Heather made me an awesome list this week, and I shared it. I'm going to give you a bonus, though. Something Heather didn't even tell me. Okay? That's like thinking on my own, on the fly. Did you know that college universities... You know, universities, colleges, campuses, they have these sororities and all that stuff. They do so many parties in the fall that it's crazy. And you can go and do, I had it, now, here's the truth to this. I've never done one of these sorority parties. Well, I've been to sorority parties, but it was when I was a lot younger and had a lot more hair. But if you, I had a vendor call me this morning. He has booked two days, two different sororities in Virginia, okay? He's in Virginia. He's got two different sorority parties. They're giving him $500 minimum, okay? And I think he told me, I think he may correct me if he's on here, 80 meals, I think it's 80 meals. And anybody, anything over that, they're going to pay him $6 a meal. And a meal is two dogs, you know, chips and a drink. So, and you have to average all that out. Because you may have somebody that gets two drinks or three drinks, but they didn't get their chips. Or they got one dog and five drinks. It just averages out. I just take roughly, if I'm doing 100, I'd take 200 drinks, 200 hot dogs, and 100 bags of chips. That's 100 meals. Let's see. So you have sororities. You have all that stuff going on. Tons of toga parties in the fall. Tons of festival parties for these sororities. You need to hit it up. Hit it up and you will make money. Tomorrow is the giveaway. Okay? Tomorrow, right there, right above where you're looking. If you're on the I Love Street Food Vending page, I know some people share this video and then they go, well, there's nothing up there except a picture of my grandmother she sent me. No, go to the I Love Street Food Vending page here on Facebook and look above at the top. There's a pinned post. Like and share it. You'll be entered into the thing. We're going to give that away. Free shipping, free everything. You don't have to do nothing. Send us your address. We send it to you. We give your address to nobody. We share your address to with no one. And we don't even keep your address because we don't care. So that will be free. Going to ship out probably Saturday, maybe Monday, depending on when we do the live show tomorrow. So you don't have to be present for the show, but you need to, in about 48 hours of hearing the winner, claim your prize, okay? You have to claim your prize. You can't. We can't be calling you up and sending you, you know, a belly dancer to your house saying you won, you won, you won. We can't do that. So you have to pay attention. Pay attention. We'll send you the gift. Period. Free. No questions asked. We do a randomizer software that picks a winner, and we announce it live right here. Now, if you are on my email list, I sent out an email last night. I've given away something that you don't want to miss. If you have any inclination or are already vending and you need, you want to be empowered, go check that email out I sent last night, and take advantage of that. It's the best thing you could do. It's the most powerful information that you could ever do, and it's free. So just take advantage of it and change your life. If you need testimonials, talk to people on the Vendors United group or the normal Facebook group, and you'll see. Okay, now, tomorrow you don't get the free ebook anymore. The free ebook, Michael Wood produced with Heather, awesome freaking ebook on cart maintenance. You have to take care of your cart. Heather actually wrote here, changing seasons, so great time to take care of those carts and keep them clean and happy, because you don't want a mad cart, okay? You want a happy cart. So it's an awesome little list of things that you might forget. It's a maintenance list for your carts or your trailers or your trucks, and it applies about anywhere. And we are fortunate enough to have a Michael Wood, who is part of our group, the Vendors United. He's a street food pro. He's helped thousands of vendors through the groups. He is an awesome guy. He's been vending for about 8 years now. He's in Georgia, Podunkville, Georgia. No joke. His cart, you can follow him on Facebook, Doug's Dogs, DUGGS DOGGS. You can follow him, check him out, and thank him for giving this away. He's giving it away, and then after tomorrow, it'll be only for the VendorsUnited.com group. And so it'll be free in there all the time. Tons of stuff in there free. But I'd take advantage of it now. Grab that link. It's right here in the information. We have so much coming up. So much coming up. You'll want to stay tuned for so that you don't miss it. I need to check something real quick. Okay, I did the book. And, oh, the giveaway tomorrow. And, I almost forgot. The vendor of the week, the new one will be announced tomorrow. Okay, we'll have a new vendor of the week tomorrow. And you can follow, like, share that. Okay, so be watching for that as well. And I did a video last night where I'm holding a hot dog up to the screen, and you ought to check that out because that's on the hot dogs page. Heather may share that over here in the I Love Street Food Vending page as well. But that video, check that out. Check that out. Change your life. Go, you know what? I'm sick of making $2,000 a month. I'm sick of making $3,000 a month. I want to make six. I want to make eight. I want to make 10. I made eight my first month right out of bankruptcy. I had nothing. Nothing. I had nothing. And I didn't even have all the information I have now about vending. I was willy-nillying this. It was like throwing spaghetti on the wall and seeing which piece sticks. And I learned so much over the years, and I've been so fortunate to be able to help so many people do the same thing. And it's so cut and dry. It's so simple. You just do this, you do this, you do this, you get these results every time. Everybody gets these results. Nobody gets a different result. We take red paint and we spray it on the wall with a paintbrush. You know, slap it on the wall with a paintbrush. We all get a red wall. That's the beauty of this business. I love you. I'll see you tomorrow. We're going to be announcing the winner. We're going to be announcing some other cool stuff. We have a lot of stuff in store for you. I cannot wait. And I'll see you over there. Love you a ton. Bye.